This is Freewell's latest ND filter. It's a veritable hard stop mist filter. It's got built-in diffusion, hard stops. It's been completely redesigned from its previous version and predecessor, yet it's still maintained the same price. Is it any good? Let's find out. What's good, everybody? Ken here, you're watching Original Dobo, and today we're taking a look at Freewell's brand new variable ND filter. This is their X Mist. Basically, you can think of this as a Polar Pro competitor. That's exactly what they're going up against. They're going up against Polar Pro's brand new Peter McKinnon filters. However, these come in at a fraction of a cost at $109 compared to Polar Pro's $249. That is absolutely insane. Now, I'm not gonna be doing any sort of direct comparisons because I don't have the Polar Pro ND filters, but in all of my ND filter testing, honestly, filters are typically, you know, good across the board. However, we wanna make sure that there's no sort of vignetting and X patterns. So those are all things that you will be able to see in the sample footage that I'm gonna display here in just a moment. Now, really quick, my version is the 82 millimeter. So they come in a maximum of 82 millimeter, but there are smaller versions. I'll leave a link down below where you can pick these up yourself. So they did go ahead and send me out both the 2-5 stop and the 6-9 stop version. So I have both of them right here. You will notice that the casing for these filters is a little bit different. Last version had like sort of this plastic clear case, which got really scratched up and then oftentimes even broke. Now it's in this nice hard aluminum case. Opening up the case, you're gonna have the filter. This is the 2-5 stop. And what I love about these filters is there's a discernible stop between the filters. Like you can feel it lock. And I'm gonna see if I can bring it close to the mic here. You can almost hear it as it locks into place on each individual stop, which is pretty awesome. One of the problems I have with variable ND filters was sometimes I would be trying to focus and I would accidentally darken my shot a little bit. So to have hard stops is really nice. I think all filters need this, but it's good to see it at this price point. Now, overall, the build quality is just as good as it was the first time. There's really nothing to gripe about. It's an all aluminum design. It feels really solid. There's 18 layers of glass comprised here, so they have the nano coating still in effect. I didn't notice any strange color cast out of this, so, you know, as far as optics go, the optics for the price are really excellent, and that's honestly what Freewell does really well over other brands, is provide incredible optics at a fraction of the cost. So I'm gonna go ahead and just play some sample footage now that I shot yesterday. Now, this sample footage was filmed 4K, 24 frames per second in V-Log into the Ninja Atmos on the Panasonic Lumix S5. So let's go ahead and roll those clips. So there you go. Now, the reason why I am not running comparison clips on this is, one, I don't have the filters, but the reality is comparisons are sort of silly. You either like the clips or you don't like the clips. And if you don't like the image, it's really simple. Don't get these filters if you don't like it. I think it's funny, like we always are doing comparisons and a lot of times we're jaded by a particular brand. So my thing is, I just buy something based upon whether I like the way it looks. So if you like the way that footage looked specifically, then you're gonna be perfectly happy and fine with these filters. And honestly, for $109, you're saving $150, which is crazy because you're not always going to have a need for this. Now, I don't know what level the diffusion is on this. I can't imagine it being an incredibly high amount of mist on here. Now, the mist portion of this is meant to sort of reduce some of that digital sharpness, which I did notice. I did notice a little bit more of a light bloom. When light hit the shots, you notice that it tends to spread a little bit more, which doesn't tend to happen a lot without filters like this in place. So for me, I like that look because I don't like things to be overly sharpened. There's nothing really attractive about having like somebody's face super sharp and being able to see their pores and every individual crevice. That's not attractive. So that's where Pro Mist filters will really come in handy. I can honestly recommend going with a larger filter, like the 82 millimeter. This is like for me the perfect size because then this will encompass all of my future lenses that I purchase. And then if I need something, I can just get a step up ring, which is costing me less than buying multiple filters. So pro tip, make sure you buy a 82 millimeter or the largest filter that you can and then just use step up rings to get where you need to go. But again, really happy. I didn't notice any crazy color cast. Previous reviewers used to say that the FreeWell filters would give like sort of a green cast to their images. I'm not seeing that. I'm not really noticing a massive color shift. I basically slapped the vintage LUT from the Lumix lineup on this, which gave it a pretty nice look, but you can achieve whatever you want out of these and also reduce some of that sharpness, especially on subjects, but really happy with these. If you wanna get a chance to, you know, get some of your own, there'll be a link down below where you can do so. But yeah, there's really not a lot to talk about. I didn't wanna make this an incredibly long review because at the end of the day, we've seen 1,000 ND filter reviews. I'm not gonna sit here and compare optics after optics. You either like what you saw or you didn't. All right, that's gonna do it. Stay original.